This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello there once again. Welcome to episode 55. We're going to talk about how exponential decay works by way of doing a half-life problem. Let's get started. Alright, our problem says the half-life of a radioactive compound is 1,000 years. If you start with 200 grams, how long will it take for the amount to be reduced to 25 grams? To begin doing an exponential decay problem, we have to first start with an exponential equation. I'll write it down now. We'll have y equals a times some base b raised to the x divided by t power. We'll go over what all this represents. The y is the amount that is left over. The A is the initial amount that you started with. The B is the base. The T is the half-life itself. And the X is the amount of time that has passed. All right. So that's what they all mean. Let's see which ones we know and which ones we don't know. The amount left is given to you because we want the amount to be reduced to 25 grams. The initial amount we also know because it says we start with 200 grams. Now for the base, because we are doing half-life, the base will be 1/2. The half-life itself is also given to you because it says 1,000 years. The only thing we don't know is the amount of time that has passed. The keywords here in the question are how long. That tells us the amount of time is missing. So what we have is an unknown in the exponent. You'll work a lot of examples that have unknowns in the exponent, so we'll go over how to handle that. First, let's put all the numbers into the equation. So we'll begin with 25 equals 200 times 1/2 raised to the x over 1,000. The first thing we should do is try to get the exponential by itself. And isolate it on the right-hand side. To do that, we're going to divide by the number in front of it. That's 200. The 200 over 200 cancels out, and 25 divided by 200 is actually just 1 over 8 if you simplify it. That's going to equal 1/2 raised to the x over 1,000 power. Now, in order to get the x that's in the exponential into a place we can solve it, we have to move the exponent down. In order to move an exponent down, we can use our log rules. But before we can use them, we have to actually take a log. Or ln is a possibility also. It doesn't matter very much which one you choose. I'm just going to go with common log this time. So we will have log of 1/8 equals log of 1/2 raised to the x over 1,000. Now, because you have a log, the exponent can be moved down. We'll move it in front of the log 1/2. So we'll have log of 1/8 equals x over 1,000 times log of 1/2. Our goal is still to try to get the x by itself. The first thing I would do is probably multiply by 1,000 on both sides. So we'll put times 1,000 and times 1,000 on both sides. The 1,000s cancel, and we'll have 1,000 log 1/8 equals x times log 1/2. Again, still trying to get the x by itself, so now we'll divide by log of 1/2. So if we divide by log of 1/2 on both sides, we'll end up with a massive fraction on the left, but the right will be completely simplified. So now all we're left with is x equals 1,000 times log 1/8 divided by log of 1/2. Now you would enter this into a calculator to simplify it. If you do, you'll end up with x equals 3,000. And that's our answer. It would take 3,000 years to start with 200 and then reduce to 25. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again next episode.